It's that time of the month. And no, I don't mean that time. It's time for me to send out 4 new comics to go get graded, and my cat, Luna, here we go, decided to come in and want to be part of this video. So if you want to know what these 4 are and you like seeing a cat in the process, stick around and I'll show you.
Go subscribe to We Love Comics.
We love comics.
This video is sponsored by PGX Grading Services. Get 1 free pressing of your choice when you grade 10 with the code WELOVECOMICSFREEPRESS. Link in description.
What is up, everybody? My name is Chris, and this is my channel, We Love Comics, and we're getting an extreme close-up of one of the 3 stray cats that I have that you don't get to see very often. Her name is Luna. She literally walked into our life 2 years ago during a snowstorm, where one day I just opened the door to go get the mail, and all of a sudden she came in, a starving cat, and we got her nice and fat, so we're taking care of her, and she decided to walk over here while I was making this video. So I have my 4 comics that I send in to PGX every month. I have a special deal with them where, as you can see in the beginning of this video, I do a quick little advertisement for their company. And my little part of the bargain is I get 4 comics every month that I can send in to be graded. And I am definitely looking forward to showing those. And it looks like Luna wants to be in the spotlight. So let me just show a quick little image. And of course, now she's being camera shy. So she's got such a beautiful face, and I have a very special place in my heart for her. Love her to death. So with that being said, let me show the 4 books. I tell you the price I paid for them, obviously. I tell you my prediction of the grades. I also include the color pages. And then in about a month to 6 weeks when I get them back, I do a live unboxing. So hopefully you will be able to check that out. And wait until the end to see who's today's surpriser. All right, let's try that again. Today's surprise subscriber shout-out. And if you'd like to be one of those, all you have to do is not be a person that can't speak like me and hit subscribe and let me know you want one and we'll give you one. Just keep in mind it may take some time. So without further ado, let's move this asunder and show the first book. And let me move the others out of the way. So the first book we have, and Luna's very excited. She wants to block it. So we're going to show you here. That is Fantastic Four. Issue number 13, that is the first appearance of the Watchers. Now, this book I acquired with a couple of different books from an eBay or a few years ago, where this person obviously did not know what they were selling or just didn't care because they accepted every one of my best offers. And this is an expensive book. And especially when they had Stan Lee reconfirm that he was indeed one of the Watchers in the Guardians of the Galaxy movie, this book definitely saw some ground. Now, this book, they had it listed for around $250. I made a offer for $100, and they accepted it. And I think this one, and to tell this person didn't know or didn't care, all the books that I bought from that person, they came without bags and boards. So this will definitely benefit from a pressing. Like I said, I paid a total of $100. Orgon wants to come in, but these two fight, so he walked over, saw Luna, and kind of did a backtrack. So unfortunately, you may not see Orgon today, but he is in the background, and he says hello to everybody if he could speak. But I'm predicting creamed off-white pages, around a 2.5 to a 3.5 range. Now, that's obviously after the pressing and dry cleaning. There are some wrinkles here, but they don't break color, and my cat wants to try and hide those so you can't see them.
Luna, don't be a ham.
There you go. Sit right there. Okay. So there's some chipping along the edge and the top. It's dirty, so dry cleaning will definitely help this book. But again, for $100, I think I got a really good deal on this book. And considering how they mailed it, I'm actually shocked that it came in one piece. So with the pressing and everything, I think that one should come out to, like I said, about a 2.5 to a 3.5. So not a high grade, but to me, like I always say, low grade is better than no grade. All right, this one will definitely be a little bit higher in grade. This is a book I've been telling people to get for a very long time. I bought this and many other copies years ago. Obviously, this is Fantastic Four, issue number 49. That is the first full appearance of Galactus and the first time Galactus and the Silver Surfer appear on a cover. A hard book to get in high grade because of the fact that it has all that black and that can show a lot of color. Color breaks. So this one maybe has about 3 or 4 color breaks along the spine. Other than that, you could see it's very glossy, even though it's got a Mylar. And that's one of the things I hate about Mylars, in my opinion, is it shows a comic looking a lot glossier than it really is. So if you're buying it on eBay, it could be very misleading. But obviously, I'm not worried about that because I always take the book out to check first. The only major defect is right here. A little piece of the cover is ripped off. But other than that, looks pretty darn good. I always check the book, so it is complete. The staples are intact. I paid a total of $64.55 for this book. And again, the only reason I got that price is I bought it years ago when most people didn't think about it, way before the announcement, because I knew eventually it was going to happen. So I'm going to predict roughly about, I'm going to narrow it in a little bit on this one. I'm going to say between a 5.0 and a 5.5 with creamed off-white pages. So definitely a book to acquire, especially if you can't afford 48, because that one's starting to get out of hand. Still have time to get that book and this one, of course, but clock's ticking. It's just a matter of time before they are in the MCU. Then forget it. Those prices are going to be unobtainable. All right, this will be the highest grade of the bunch. This is a book, again, I have like five or six copies of. I bought them like about 2015, 2016. This obviously is Marvel Spotlight, issue number 5. This is the first appearance of Johnny Blaze as the Ghost Rider. Keep in mind, it's not the first appearance of the Ghost Rider because there was one years earlier where he was on horseback. But that wasn't nearly as popular as Johnny Blaze with his 70s motorcycle. Another book I was telling people to get years ago, I paid only $175. And of course, the prices that I have always include shipping and handling. And the best part about this book is the dirt that you may see here probably won't be able to, but that's on the actual bag, not on the comic. There is really not much wrong with this book. One or two little hairline right here. Like, I mean, I'm talking microscopic little indents. I mean, the corners rounded a little bit, and there is a little bit of what looks like a color breaking crease, but at the very tip. And right here, there is a small color-breaking crease, and that's it. As you could see, this cover is complete, especially for a black cover, because all along the spine, these tend to show a lot of color breaks. And as you can see, not any major to be found. Of course, staples are intact. Looks beautiful inside. This looks like a book that's never been read. And I'm looking forward to seeing what the grade is. I'm not as good as the lower grades in grading higher grades. So we'll see how bad I am or how right I was, considering I don't have many higher grade books to go on. I have a lot of lower grades, but again, low grade is better than no grade. But I'm going to predict this is going to be about a 6.5 to a 7.5. I'd be even happy with a 5.0 if it got that low, but I don't think it's going to be that low. And Luna doesn't want you to see this one for some reason. And it's got white pages. Beautiful inside. It, like I said, when I opened it, it definitely looks like that book was never read. So definitely a great book to add. All right, last but not least, this is a book I've shown before. This is like my fourth or fifth copy. And again, for those of you who love the cat, she's got the most gorgeous eyes. Friendliest cat you'll ever know. Somebody knocks on my door or comes in that she's never seen before, she'll just go up and start purring and want to be pet. So, like I said, definitely love this cat. But let's slide this over. And the last but not least, we got another Giant Size X-Men issue number 1. Of course, this is the first appearance of Storm. We got Colossus. We got Thunderbird. We got Nightcrawler. And the second full Wolverine. So definitely a book. Again, just like the Fantastic Four, this is a book to acquire because of the fact that, let me move this over again, with the X-Men ending up in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, these books, again, they're getting out of reach, but they are, you ain't seen nothing yet. So I have a feeling if they bring the X-Men to the MCU, I think they're going to go with these X-Men other than the original X-Men. I mean, of course, you'll have your Cyclops, and you probably have your Iceman, but I think they're going to focus more on these characters. But I guess we'll see, and Luna wants to jump back in. So I paid a total of $0 on this book because I got this using my eBay bucks a couple of years back. So this could come back a 0.5, and I would not care. but this is definitely not a 0.5 book. One of the good things you could tell about this book is when they get crushed, the whole side you could read from the front. Now, you could see the majority, well, you might not be able to see, but the majority of it is, it's kind of like on a slant a little bit, so it's not completely crushed, so a pressing could help this book. It has white pages on the inside, so the inside is beautiful. It's another one of those books. This is a book that a pressing and a dry cleaning will help. It's got some minor indentation here, which is normal considering this is such a thick book. As you can see, 68 pages. There's a couple of color breaks here, but nothing major. Like some minor chipping at the bottom, a little rounded at the corners. And there's a little bit of a split right there on the cover, but it goes about an inch. So that's not going to lower the grade dramatically. But this is definitely not an 8 or a 9 grade comic. But as you can see, the giant size X-Men logo itself, very red, looks very bright. The colors of the characters are still retaining its gloss, so definitely presents well. Again, I paid $0, so I don't care what this grade is, but I'm going to say roughly between a 5.0 and a 6.0 with white pages. So those are the four books. We got Giant Size X-Men number 1. We got Marvel Spotlight on the Ghost Rider number 5. We got Fantastic Four 49. And we have Fantastic Four number 13. So I'll be sending those out. Not sure when this video will be uploaded because I still have some other videos, because I have some comics that are yet to arrive that will be on my top list. So I was originally going to start doing my top list soon. I might be able to do my top 15 of the slabbed comics before this year ends, but I may have to do the three-part set of the unslabbed books starting at the beginning of 2019. So it's a three-part series because there's going to be 60 books that I have that are definitely video worthy for that list of the top 60 books that I got in 2018. And that's not including all the others that I got. So stick around for those. If you saw this far, let me know that you're looking forward to those top videos, because I always appreciate those who take the time to watch the entire video. So thumbs up to you guys that do that. Let me know what you thought about these books. Let me know if you think those grades seem pretty decent. Give your own predictions if you want. Wait until the end to see who's today's surprise subscriber shout-out. And if you'd be so kind, in the comment section, if you are kind enough to leave a comment, let people that got the shout-out be acknowledged by you guys by sending a little message that you include in your comment. So, thumbs up are always appreciated. Hit the share button if you want other people to see this. And hit the subscribe button if you aren't subscribed. And just don't hit the person next to you because, you know, we don't want to punch this time of year. Or any time of the year. So thanks for watching. Don't forget, this is you. It's not I. It's We Love Comics. And yes, I actually screwed up my own catchphrase. Go figure.
Thank you for watching my video. If you want to connect with me on Facebook, just click right here. If you want to join our cashback program and get $10 off your first purchase of $25 or more, click here. And then if you aren't subscribed, we'd love you to join by clicking here.